I would like to thank the Scientific Board for this opportunity. I will present some challenging cases of endophthalmitis associated with intraocular foreign body, in which a second vitrectomy was performed at a short time once the infection was eradicated and the retina restored. We know that in endophthalmitis, the SIEVE study advocates an early and complete vitrectomy to get better results. But sometimes we have to struggle with corneal opacities, retinal necrosis, continuous bleeding, and very long surgeries. So our surgical steps can be incomplete and not conclusive. I'm just going to show two videos of our cases. The first one was a young man in which the surgery was soon hindered by continuous bleeding, proceeding slowly from anterior to posterior. We finally could detect and detach the posterior hyoid, then remove the foreign body and tamponade with oil. Carefully monitoring the patient with OCT, when we noticed after 20 days an initial contraction of the residual hyoid, we performed a second vitrectomy to complete the peeling and to clean the scar. And after 1 year, the retina is still attached without complications. The second case was a man with an advanced endophthalmitis, very haze vitreous, and retinal necrosis. We removed the foreign body stuck into the retina and peeled off the vitreous membrane from the retinal wound, while in the macular area, we gently vacuumed the pus. After 15 days, eradicated infection, we completed the peeling and removed the oil in the second surgery, and after 6 months, visual acuity stabilized on 20/40 without any complications. In conclusion, we want to point out that in some complex surgeries for endophthalmitis, if a complete vitrectomy cannot be done within the safety limits, a second vitrectomy should be performed into 3 weeks to complete the retinal maneuvers in less risky conditions. This way, we can achieve a good final outcome, avoiding further complications. Thank you.